I want to share with you an interesting board on this week's Parasha. The Gemara tells us in Maseches Brachos that the Avos were Mesakein Tfilos, that the Avos were the first to daven. Avram was Mesakein Tfilos Shachris, Yitzchak was Mesakein Tfilos Mincha, and Yaakov was Mesakein Tfilos Avos. Yaakov was the first to daven Maariv. Where do we see that? So we see that in the dream. It says that when he comes to Har Mor, it says, Vayivka b'makom, and he met that place. So the Gemara Darshins in Maseches Brachos, ain't pigia ela tefila. What is pigia? It means tefila. That Yaakov came to the place of Hara Moriah, as we discussed, and he davened Maariv, because we know it was dark, and that's when he had the dream. So the question is, what's the significance of Yaakov davening Maariv? So there's a very interesting idea I saw from Pesach Krohn. If you notice in the morning, after Kriyat Shema, we say V'yatziv, V'nachon, V'kayam, V'yashar. We talk about how everything is clear. The world is clear. We see HaKadosh Baruch Hu's world with clarity. The sun is shining. It's all bright and it's all great. At night, we change the text. We say Emes V'amuna. We say V'amuna Kozos, that we believe that it's all there. Why? What's the difference? Because at night, when it's dark and you don't see everything so clear, in order to connect to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it has to be based on the concept of having emuna, of having faith. We believe, despite the darkness, despite what we see, that it's all there and it's all great and HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to protect us. Now, how does that connect to Yaakov Avinu? So symbolically, in Chazal, night represents Golos. Yaakov Avinu was the Av that went into Golos. Yitzchak was never allowed to leave Eretz Yisrael. Avraham only temporarily went into Golos, but came right back. Yaakov spent a significant portion of his life in Golos. And Yaakov Avinu went on a journey that was potentially dark, and he didn't know how it was going to turn out. And he begins his journey with V'yamuna Kozos. He begins his journey with Maariv. Like, it's dark, and I don't know what's going to happen, but it begins with Maariv. And Yaakov Avinu teaches us that sometimes the world is dark for us. Sometimes we don't see the light at the end of the tunnel. And Yaakov Avinu was heading for a completely uncertain life. He did not know how it was going to turn out. And Yaakov Avinu teaches us that there's one thing that will guide our journey, and Emunah Kozos. That if we have faith in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and we daven Maariv, we daven that the darkness should turn into light, then all is going to turn out really great. And it's Stavka Yaakov who went into Golos. And later on, she marries Rachel, and Rachel is symbolic of the Tfilos, of the Am Yisrael going into Golos. It's Yaakov Avinu who teaches, and then at the end of Yaakov Avinu's life, he goes to Mitzrayim. Yaakov Avinu teaches us that we can go to Golos, we can leave Eretz Yisrael, and we can still have our faith, and we can dial into HaKadosh Baruch Hu that He should protect us, and that there is a light at the end of the tunnel of darkness. Yaakov understood that when he goes to Mitzrayim, he knew that eventually there's going to be a Yitzias Mitzrayim. When he goes to Lavan, he knew there's going to be a light at the end of the tunnel. He had an inclination that he's going to come back and all is going to be well. But it all begins with Tfilas Maariv. It all begins with that darkness. When we think we're deep in darkness, have emunah. Believe in HaKadosh Baruch Hu and daven Maariv. So it's Davka Yaakov who had all those experiences and who was setting the tone for the Jewish people in the future. It's Davka Yaakov Avinu who's Mesakein Tfilas Maariv. He davens when there's darkness to teach us that in darkness, all you need is a little bit of a spark and a little bit of a light, and it's all going to be okay. Thank you for listening, and have a great Shabbos.